Friends, we are going to start our new topic, which is actually accounting of platelets. We have already studied about the counting of leukocytes and RBCs, and we have already discussed about the total eosinophil count. Today's topic is actually very important, because in many or in number of clinical conditions, thrombocytopenia or excessive formation of platelets has been observed. So for clinical diagnosis, counting of platelets, exact number of platelets in a patient serum, in a patient blood, is very important. So what is the principle of the platelet count? First of all, the blood is diluted with a fluid that causes hemolysis of RBCs, because we require just platelets. So it will be better to hemolyze the RBCs to eliminate RBCs from blood to compensate or to protect ourselves, protect calculation or counting from error or disturbance or contamination. So removal of RBCs or lysis of RBCs is done with the diluting fluid. So blood is diluted with a fluid that causes hemolysis of RBCs but has no effect on platelets, which can then be counted in counting chamber. So this is a very simple principle and the clear cut principle RBCs are actually RBCs should be hemolyzed and the platelets then counted on Neubauer chamber. We have already studied about the Neubauer chamber. So counting how and where we should calculate the platelet in the Neubauer chamber. Let's talk about the other detail of it. First of all, we should prepare our equipments, or we should adopt requirements for our proper experiment. Like first of all, Thoma white cell pipette is a main pipette which is Meyring pipette, which is required for the dilution or calculating amount of a fluid or blood in for analysis. Neubauer chamber is actually a very much important device, because without Neubauer chamber we are unable to calculate platelet on simple glass, right? So Neubauer chamber is actually there with special kind of boxes and with special measured boxes. So counting through Neubauer chamber is actually important. Diluting fluid, we use diluting fluid 1% ammonium oxalate to hemolyze the RBCs. Ammonium oxalate is unable to lyse the platelet, so platelet became active or intact, and the RBCs become hemolyzed. Mechanical counter, if it is there, then it will be a better. Otherwise, we can count manually as well. Blood sample from which we need platelet count. Microscope is a major instrument. What is the procedure of the platelet count? First of all, we will make dilution. We are studying from our many our previous 3 to 4 lectures how to make a dilution. So first of all, the dilution will be through Thoma white cell pipette is a good way, and on the other hand dilution in external test tube is also an easy procedure. So dilution, if you have already studied carefully about the dilution, then this dilution is same like others. Then this dilution making is not too much hard or other we can say that the this dilution is very much simple. Then after formation of dilution with the diluting fluid, we will add calculated amount of diluted blood sample on new bar chamber. So first question is, there are five big boxes in the new bar chamber, so we will use central big scale for platelet counting. First of all we have used a corner big scale for leukocyte count, but here we will use central big scale for platelet count for platelet counting, as we have already count RBC, as we have already counted RBCs in a central big scale. And then after proper loading or charging of new bar chamber, we will calculate the platelets through microscope, and then we will count the platelet on with the microscope, and then we will calculate the next formula. So after counting platelets in central big scale, we can calculate exact platelet count through this formula. First of all, the formula is actually similar with other with many previous formulas, just with a slight change. Like we will count the cell through microscope in a central big scale, and then we will multiply it with the dilution factor, and the dilution factor was 20, and then we will divide the volume. So volume of the because how you in erythrocyte count you have studied at the volume of central big scale, so volume of central big scale is actually related with the previous lecture. So then we will calculate the after multiplication of counted number of platelet with the 1000, then we will calculate the total we will finalize our result. Normal values of actually platelets in our blood is 150,000 to 400,000 per cubic millimeter. So units are much important. If you are talking about 150,000 to 400,000, then unit will be per cubic millimeter. So usually reading chamber is actually readings with new bar chamber readings with new bar chamber are expected in the cubic millimeter. What is thrombocytopenia? Thrombocytopenia is actually a condition in which body suffers with the deficiency of platelet below normal range. It means if any person is suffering from platelet deficiency at the number of platelet count is less than 150,000 per cubic millimeter, then it is known as thrombocytopenia. And what is thrombocytosis? Thrombocytosis is the formation of excessive number of platelets. It means number of platelets usually more than 400,000 per cubic millimeter is actually a thrombocytosis. But sometimes usually a minor thrombocytopenia or minor thrombocytosis are have no significant results or no significant sign and symptoms, or sometimes you can say it happens just due to a slight physiological change in our body. So severe thrombocytopenia and severe thrombocytosis can be dangerous and are common sign and symptom of many clinical diseases. So here you can see some important examples of thrombocytopenia and thrombocytosis. In next two slides, there will be name of some diseases or clinical condition in which we can observe thrombocytosis and thrombocytopenia. So ये सब चीज़ें जो हैं इस लेक्चर में इम्पोर्टेंट हैं. प्लेटलेट काउंट जो है आप लोगों को मैनुअली आना चाहिए. नो डाउट ऑटोमेशन जो है उसने मैनुअल मेथड्स को ख़त्म कर दिया है, बट मैनुअल काउंटिंग की हमें उस वक्त ज़रूरत होती है जब हमारी ऑटोमेशंस के रिजल्ट्स ठीक नहीं होते. सो ये आज का लेक्चर था. होप इन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड्स को आप देख लीजिएगा, उनमें कोई भी ऐसी चीज़ नहीं है, बस आपको नाम याद रखने हैं, डिजीज़ की डिटेल की ज़रूरत नहीं है. थैंक यू सो मच.